out. Great as hair.
Our next comedian from Kill Tony Podcast on DeathSquad.tv, live taping every Monday at Comedy Store in LA. Tony Hinchcliffe is joining us.
That I would fool around with a married man. You're married indeed. You're married to me. Greg's dad's legs are our Greg's dad's feet are so sweet. I wanna suck on them. Yum, 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 yum. Suck on them feet. Greg's dad's feet are so sweet. I wanna dip them in raspberry vodka and then kill myself. Greg's dad's balls are so weird. I wanna study them. I wanna study them, cause those are straight-edge balls. Greg's dad's balls are so weird. I wanna show them off to all of my friends and then kill myself. I wanna be your greasy baby in the morning. I wanna sop up your creamy gravy in the night. You're the king of my heart till death do us part.
Song now called Song from a Pop Punk Band, parentheses, like Blink 182.
My parents are fighting, my girlfriend won't fuck me. I'm trapped in the suburbs, and I've never seen a black person. I hate you, Dad. I hate you, Mom. Why won't you buy me an iPad? My life is so hard. She left me roses by the stairs. Surprises let me know she cares. Goodbye, my love. I've had enough, and enough is enough. No more Greg's dad. Moving on to Greg's grandpa Chad. He's 71 years old, and he takes gas station boner pills. 71 years old, just my kind of man.
chokes me out when we fuck. Fuck, fuck, fuck. I yank his D, he eats my butt. He loves eating butt. His one life's joy, eating the butt of a 10-year-old boy. Eating the butt of a 10-year-old boy. That's me. I'm the boy in that story. A boy who reads Graham Greene and reads Pearl S. Buck and reads Mark Twain and also who fucked Greg's grandpa. Thank you. I've been working on, I've been working on punch-ups lately, song punch-ups of like popular songs. It's gonna be short. This is the last thing I'm gonna do. Josh Martin, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, Josh.
I've been working on song punch-ups lately. And I punched up that song by the Pixies, that band. I punched up Where Is My Mind? I think I might have improved on it a little bit, but anyways, here's my version of that song, and then we're gonna start Kill Tony. Woo! I said, and then, where is my dad? Where is my dad? Where is my dad? Never at my soccer games or dinner. With your friends at the park and your mom at her job. You tried weed once and then again, yeah. Your head had collapsed, but there was nothing in it. And you asked yourself, where is my dad? Where is my dad? Where is my dad? In another country with another family. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. That's it for me. Y'all ready to start the show? Y'all ready to start the show? All right, let's do it.
Hey, this is Red Band coming to you live from the Road Famous Comedy Store for a brand new episode of Kill Tony Volume 3. Give it up for Tony Hensley!
Yeah! Yeah! Oh my god, listen to that nice cold night applause. Hi everybody, welcome. How you guys doing? Fuck yeah. How fun. Come on, you can make some more noise than that. Make some noise, my man. Yeah, we're live to tons of people live on Ustream right now. We got a live audience here. It's Monday night for another fun episode of Kill Tony. Brian Redband's here, ladies and gentlemen.
What's up, guys? Come on. Yeah.
Ryan J. Ebelt has a blank piece of paper in front of him. That's because he's the house artist and he draws every episode. And he's going to draw tonight's episode. That's Ryan J. Ebelt. Yeah. Instagram, Ryan J. Ebelt.
You can get on the past on his website. Like he does prints of all his stuff.
Everything's available on RyanJEbelt.com. Jamie Vernon in the back.
Yeah.
On the two HD cameras.
With a new haircut that he's hiding with his hat.
Captain Bad haircut. Kevin Lee Light, Hollywood Jesus Christ, is here.
Yeah.
Special guest, everybody, the resurrection. And the great sounds of Pat Reagan, everybody. There he is. Comics running around, shit's gonna get crazy tonight. You guys ready for a fun night or what?
Yeah.
I know, I'm excited. I just flew in back from Australia today. I did sold out theaters with Joe Rogan, and then I was right next to the Octagon when Holly Holm stunned the world. Yeah. The new champion.
I heard you could see her face throughout the whole thing, making faces.
I was on screen. If you look at pretty much every highlight except for the kick.
Did you know you were? Because I know in the past Ari Shaffir and Duncan Trussell made out together.
Everybody was going crazy. It just so happened to be, you know, there's like five cameras around the octagon. It just so happened to be that the action was taking place and I was in the background. Just, I gave a touchdown at one point. I didn't realize I did it, but a bunch of people said that on Twitter. Like, did Tony just give a touchdown at the UFC? I took her down and I was like, oh my god. It was amazing. It's like the coolest thing I've ever been to.
I saw online that you're about to get your ass kicked by Cyborg.
Well, no, she's definitely not going to kick my ass.
She says she's coming to a show.
I'm hoping she comes to a show so I can make fun of her fucking man head. So here's what happened. Let me explain, because I know none of you know what the fuck Brian's talking about. It's the Twitter battle just started a couple hours ago.
Yes.
I did a podcast on the way home last night with Joe Rogan and Dana White, the owner of the UFC, and we did this huge podcast that is going to be listened to by millions of people because we're just coming back off the Rousey thing. And we started talking about how the UFC should do a roast, and like they're like, Tony, how would you make fun of... Chris Cyborg, who is a female in another fighting league that took male hormones and now completely has the jaw, you know, everything changes. People get fucking touchy with this man-woman shit. Everybody relax. She took male hormones to become a bigger, better fighter. Makes sense. And she took too many of them and basically turned into a man. And now she's trying to like come back and like be all feminine and clean and everything, but it's too late. She's, if you see her face, let me just catch you idiots up. If you see this girl's face, you could see that she is man features now. Anyway, I made a joke. They go, how would you make fun of Chris Cyborg? And I was on the spot. I go, she's the only female fighter that cuts weight by cutting off her dick. Oh, really? That's too much? It's a fucking on-the-spot roast joke. They're like, Tony, how can you do this? That's not how it works.
Guys, I want to introduce to the stage, Cyborg!
All right, Brian, I see what you did there. What do you think, I was going to get scared? No, I will roast her right now. Come on out, Cyborg.
Well, I think you're being harsh. You're calling her a man figure.
Yeah,
you know?
She took male hormones. Look, I don't call other women men, all right? How about that? I don't do that, because that's not right. I have funnier ways to make fun of women.
I would still hit it.
I bet you would. You would fuck this bucket.
I love you, Cyborg. I have no problem with your beautiful face. I think you are amazing.
I'd love to see you say that to her face.
I would.
Why do all these UFC fighters have alliteration in their names? Chris Cyborg, Holly, whatever, Hulk, Ronda Rousey.
Wow.
It's like, maybe
you're onto something.
Juice.
Jamie Juice.
Oh, there you go. That was the big payoff. Jamie Juice. You pitched up a big beach ball to yourself and you just smacked it down into the ground.
Oh, shame. We actually have protection here anyways, guys. Tate Fletcher, everybody.
Oh, yes.
The house.
Oh, yes. The great Tate.
You just missed the Cyborg talk.
You know anything about this? I made fun of Cyborg on the Rogan podcast last night.
No. Cyborg, the man or the woman?
Yes! Oh, exactly. Thank you!
He's saying there's two fighters.
Yeah. One is male and one is questionably female.
Yes, exactly. Well, she's mad at me right now.
There's a good argument to be made that she's fully female.
That's right. Maybe. Who knows?
Attracted or not?
Brian is.
What, true, Brian?
No, I'm just covering his ass because she's going to come to one of these shows and beat him up.
She's not.
I don't want any part of it.
Yeah, she's going to fly from Brazil up here.
What?
Anyway, so I'm not backing down from this Cyborg thing. If she wants to come and fight me, you know what? Bring it, lady. I'll fucking take you on. Because you know what? I'm a pretty feminine guy. And you're a pretty manly chick. And I don't know exactly where, how far off we are. So it might be fair. And I'm pretty sure we're in the same weight class. But if we fight, you're game. Then we have to have a roast battle here the next week. And then you fight me on my field, my terms. Yeah, you have to do 60 seconds, Chris Cyborg. All right, anyway, that's what happened. Let's do tonight's show. You guys ready or what? Every week I have two of my funniest friends, two of the funniest comedians in the world on this show. This week's no different. Put your hands together for Theo Von and Fahim Anwar. Two guys that I work with almost every single night. Theo Von, you have a new special coming out in February on Netflix, everybody. Come on! First time on the show, we're going to have fun. It's going to be a blast. Fahim Anwar is back.
Hey, what's up?
Put your hands together for Fahim, everybody. Close friends with Lance Anastopoulos, one of the sensations here at the Comedy Store. Fahim is known as one of the only people that he'll hang out with, which is pretty fucking cool. I mean, I know I get to work with some cool people, and it's always fun when, you know, get to have cool friends.
Yeah, man.
So welcome to the show, guys. We're gonna have a blast tonight. Over 50 comedians signed up for the chance to do 60 seconds on this stage.
Dang, really?
We get to talk to them afterwards about anything in the world that we want to. They get 60 uninterrupted seconds. Comedians, you know your 60 seconds is up when you hear the sound of a kitty. Come on, kitty, you can be a little bit louder than that. Okay, I guess you can't be louder than that in a room with subwoofers. But you better wrap it up then, or else you're gonna bring out the angry West Hollywood bear. That's the point that he makes, that how loud it can get after the cat's quiet. So, guys, keep your ears open for that cat that you don't hear. There you go. Or just the gunshot. Pretty much, all right.
Trump. Is that Trump?
Yeah, he's here. He's here, and we have Hollywood Jesus is here, and we're expecting a pop-in from Ron Jeremy for the second week in a row. I'm serious, but that's not a joke. He was here last week. Sorry, those are just the types of badass motherfuckers. He actually hit a comedian in the face with his dick at one point, and he was sitting on the balcony.
That was good. Last year?
No, it was last
week.
Week.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Mm-hmm. He's still doing that.
Ron Jeremy, hitting it hard. Guys, you ready to start tonight's episode or what? Here we go. Here we go. The number one live podcast in the world. That's right. Yeah. Bring it, Doug Loves Movies. We are here. Oh, yeah. Columbus and Pittsburgh, November 27th and 29th.
Yeah.
How about that? Kill Tony live and stand-up shows afterwards. You can get a combo packet for that if you want to sit through a six-hour comedy show. You can watch both shows.
And the winner of that, we were going to pick one person from each Kill Tony show to open up for us on the
right.
comedy show.
Whichever 60 seconds we like the most on Kill Tony gets to open up and do 5 minutes, 3 minutes, 2 minutes on the gets to do that same 60 seconds half an hour later. I pulled the name out of the bucket. Your first comedian doing 60 seconds uninterrupted tonight goes by the name of Tom McNaughton.
You guys ever notice that when a pregnant lady says that she's eating for two, she never seems to realize that second one is just a baby? You guys stop laughing, I only got like 30 seconds. Or you think that when a fat guy chokes to death, people are like, well, at least he died doing what he loved. I'll take that chuckle. My God. What else do they got? It's about a Milky Way. On the side of the Milky Way wrapper, it says, warning, may contain peanuts. It's like, that's stupid. You should just say, Milky Way might be a Snickers. when I bought it, I had to sign for it. They gave me one of those pens with a spoon taped to it. It's like, what the hell is that? It's like, if I take it, I just get more shit, right? It's like, what about the people buying soup?
Tom McNaughton. Am I saying that right? Tom McNaughton.
Yes.
Fuck yeah, welcome to the show. First time, right?
Yes.
This is some funny jokes. How long have you been on stand-up?
About 8 years.
Wow. Where are you from?
Minneapolis.
And you've been doing most of it there?
Yeah.
How long have you been here?
About 8 months.
8 months. Wow.
Yes.
Fuck, everything's in eights with you.
Yeah.
I like your style.
How many women have you had sex with?
Oh, interesting. Tom McNaughton
welcome me to the show.
I'm guessing none. I'm guessing
shirt. You got Puma shoes.
I'm guessing he hasn't had sex with anyone. I'm guessing he just ate them out. See that?
Just warming up. Just warming up over here. It flew 17 hours today from Australia, you motherfuckers.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. First class. No big deal. You know, just the type of life I'm living. Anyway.
You think you could have sex in a first class bed and anyone would stop you?
There's no question that you could. I didn't do it.
They will stop you.
No. Yeah, no, there's a way to do it. No,
they'll stop you for fingering your girlfriend on a bus to Florida. Swear to God.
Really?
Yeah.
How did they know?
They know, man.
You gotta go under a blanket.
Yeah, I was under a blanket, and this brother actually tried to get involved. No offense if anybody's a brother.
What did he try to do? Throw a finger in there or something?
I mean, he was trying to get in there, bro. I mean, anybody was game at that point.
I watched people have sex on a plane before, a red eye. And
really?
It was like a half-empty plane, and the row next to me had two people sitting on each side of the aisle. I went to sleep, woke up at like 3 in the morning, pitch black in the plane, and they were on top of each other.
Well, it was the same?
Huh?
Who was it?
It was like they didn't even know each other. And then when the plane landed, they both just went their separate ways.
Imagine how weird they felt when they looked over and saw you sitting there by yourself masturbating.
Yeah, I know.
They're probably just like, man, the ball's on this guy. Anyway, let's keep fucking. Come inside of me. Anyway, Tom, I mean, I'm going to follow through with Pat's question. How many people have you had sex with?
Probably around 8.
There you go. Nailed it. We gave you a beach ball and you did it. There you go. Tom, can I tell you, I love the fact, and I think this is very Minnesota of you, that you dress like a college football coach.
Except for the pants. The pants, he dresses like the seventh, no, fifth, eighth. Oh,
all
fifth,
right.
Fourth, he's like a fourth grade girl.
There you go.
Players.
Jesus, wow. He just follows through the pistol now. It's not even enough to shut him up.
You gotta give a warning on that thing, because I almost shit myself.
It's all right.
You did a great job. I thought it was super funny, man.
Really tight jokes. And it was a bold move up top just to, like, not ride that energy.
You just kind of sit there and make a song.
Yeah. You're like, thanks, but no thanks.
Yeah. You're like, I'm getting mine. I left home for this.
Yeah, exactly. That, and then I like how after joke two, you kind of look at the panel just to, like, see how I'm doing, you know? You're like, yeah, that's right, guys.
I heard that.
But
heavy
then also... It's not good if, like, two jokes deep, you're like, what did I want to do?
It felt like you were going for the notes.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
by
yeah.
the way you're dressed, maybe the playbook.
No. That's nerves. I'm sure you're doing it. I was fucking nervous, man.
I'll tell you, this is more of the minute thing.
I
don't
want to
get
bared.
It's always hard to do a minute, but, I mean, you just got to follow through and get out what you can.
But what a great style to have
right.
for a minute.
Exactly. I'll tell you this, Tom, is that I love the eating for two joke with the baby.
Yeah.
And I'd say that you can extend that, you know what I mean? There's definitely tags to be had there. Like, you know, because you're already in it. So you can go longer with that, you know what I mean? Like, if she eat for tooth, but they never mention it's a baby. Like, I've never seen a baby eat, you know,
a half of
a full pizza. I haven't seen a baby eat a cigarette.
You know the Earth's 10 months pregnant?
Uh-oh.
I feel like there's a
punchline. We're due for a natural disaster. We're over the 9-month moment and we're 10 months pregnant, so I just want to throw that out there.
Really?
Yep.
Is your performance tonight perhaps that disaster that we're overdue for? Because right now we're feeling there's a little bit of a fucking shift in the tectonic plates of this show.
Just saying. Just throwing out there, we're talking pregnancy.
You're doing even better now, Tom.
I'm just trying to pretend like I'm not here.
Do you know how to play guitar, Tom? We might need you to be the band tonight.
No, I don't. Sorry. I can try, though.
What do you do for fun? What's your favorite thing about LA? Like, what are you into, other than stand-up comedy?
Definitely poker.
Have you seen Mississippi Grind?
No.
You should go see it. It's better than Rounders.
Oh, boy.
It's a movie with Ryan Reynolds and Ben Mendelsohn.
What was it called?
His name Ben Mendelsohn.
When did that come out?
Ben Mendelsohn?
Classical composer, Mendelsohn.
It's a guy from Bloodline. He's this new actor.
Oh, fuck, he's so good.
He's so good, and he's amazing to watch. He's actually Australian, and he's this freak of nature actor that you can't even tell is Australian, but every character he plays, especially in Bloodline, he's always drunk. and everything's gonna be okay. Like, he's that guy. We're like, you worry too much. Everything's gonna be fine. Like, nonstop and everything. And he's that way.
He's Australia's Owen Wilson.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, Tom. So how much poker are we talking about here?
Well, right now I'm unemployed, so not much. But yeah, usually I play a fair amount. I like to play tournaments over cash.
What's the most you've ever won?
In a single tournament, like 1,700.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
How much did you buy in for?
65. So it's pretty good payout.
$65,000?
$65.
Okay. Well, Tom, how do you think things are going? You're 8 months in. That's a pretty, like, now you sort of see what you're dealing with in Los Angeles. How do you feel about things?
So far, pretty good. Running a comedy show at a Hooters, so.
The one here down the street?
Yeah, across from the Chinese Theater on Wednesdays at 9, so if you guys want to show up, come on by.
This is just like an elaborate plug for his Hooters show.
How's the Hooters grocer?
When you kill a minute, you get a plug of your show, right?
How's the Hooter quality of the girls there? Because I noticed in Los Angeles, it's a different kind of Hooters than
it's not. It's not good. Tom's actually one of the waitresses.
There's no good Hooters. And I don't want to say anything further because this is a podcast, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
No. Nothing's being recorded. No, just ignore Brian over here. He's just a very distracted audience.
Nothing's being recorded. It's fucking disgusting.
What did I tell you about texting during the show?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right, Tom. It was nice to meet you. Fun times. You got to plug your show. Go to Hooters. Tom McNaughty. He's on Twitter at Tommy McNaughty.
Get it, Tom.
All the way from Minnesota. Just a good old boy. This weather out there today is good for me. I like it like this, windy and cold.
Tom should stop breathing in the mic so much. I think he's got kind of. I wanted to give him that note. It's got kind of. It's just
he's
don't breathe.
It's a little creepy sound. You breathe. You have to breathe.
Yeah.
You should stop breathing and you should stop talking.
You didn't notice?
I guess you're right.
It was a wrong point to interject and put it in, but.
I pulled another name out of the bucket. The show goes on. Put your hands together for Matthew Maloney.
Oh, wow.
Alliteration, baby. Hey. UFC fighter.
All right, heads up, everybody. I'm coming in like halfway through my set about time travel. All right. So what this means is everyone in this room is alive thanks to Adolf Hitler. So you can't go back in time to kill Hitler because that would mean that you would never exist. And I know some of you are thinking, that doesn't matter to me. I would still go back in time. It's the right thing to do. I would still kill Hitler. If it means I would never exist. It doesn't fucking work that way! This isn't Back to the Future where you'll just start fading away from photographs. That doesn't make any sense! If you don't exist, why would anyone take your picture? Do you think if Marty had failed to get his parents back together, George McFly would have just walked around with pictures of no one in his wallet? George, like, why do you have all these pictures of nobody? Oh, those are just the pictures of the children that I don't have.
Yes, go.
Okay. Those are pictures of the people that I don't have. If I... Stop.
Matthew Maloney in what has got to be one of the funniest performances by a Best Boy employee. It's so good, I fucked it up.
Best Boy is a local youth service.
It is. He's a combination between Best Buy and Bob's Big Boy, so it actually does make sense. I wish I could go back in time and change that show. Wow, there he goes. He plays right into it. This guy's a fucking star.
That's funny, that is.
Matthew Maloney, an absolute slaughter fest here tonight. That's fucking great. Even your nipples are hard at that performance. Fuck yeah, crush this, dude.
It's
so fun.
Is that a longer joke? Is that just like a piece of it? Because that was really well done.
I just did it for the first time last night, actually, about like a 7-minute thing on why it's a bad idea to go back in time and kill Hitler. And it did really well, and an old Jewish man came up to me after the show and said that was very smart and very funny. I thought, wow, if anyone were to hate this, it would be you, so that's great.
Yeah. You could perhaps convince the Jews that, like, it was all a positive. You know, I'm saying it might not only work at the Comedy Store, I think it'll work at Temple, too. Which is huge.
Yeah, and if you work for free, they might let you in.
Boom. There you go. I'm almost happy he left the mic on the panel just so that his special is still coming out on Netflix in February. You don't want those kind of hear those jokes. Matthew, what nationality are you?
German.
Wow. Okay. Wow.
Very cool.
Fuck yeah. Look at that. The little German sneaking in his Don't Kill Hitler.
Yeah.
I love that. So fucking fun, Matthew. You're just fucking a little killer, huh? How long you been doing stand-up?
3 years.
3 years. Where at?
Just, you know, around.
In L.A.?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's great.
It's Holocaust memorials.
Fuck yeah, Matthew. I like your style. I like your haircut. It's very fun. Fits you well. You know, you're definitely one of the funniest lesbians we've ever had. Do you play softball at all? You really should. Because I know you'd be good. What do you do for fun?
I don't know. That's a boring question. Let's talk about, like, I was a Boy Scout. Can we go there?
Yeah.
I was an Eagle Scout.
Me too.
Eagle Scout.
So, really?
There we go.
Oh, really?
He did, like, his own, like, pre-interview with himself, I feel like.
What?
Did you get molested during Cub, Boy, or Eagle?
Life Scout, right before Eagle.
Life Scout.
Yeah.
Life Scout.
That's like when the tits came in, so.
Was your Boy Scouts connected to a church? Because my Boy Scouts with a church organization.
Very much not so.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you still have it?
Still have what?
Like all the costumes and...
It wasn't a costume, Brian. It was a uniform.
It's used as a costume.
Yeah, I don't think they're costumes.
They are now. Like the neckties and stuff. It's fine.
Well, that's fun, Matthew. You've been getting a lot of spots, going up a lot.
I'm trying.
Where do you live?
Palm Springs.
Palm Springs.
You live in Palm Springs?
So then where do you get up around? Do you get up around Palm Springs?
No, I drive out here and I... I'm an Uber driver, so I drive out here and I do all my business during the day and then I, you know...
Do you try to find a ride, somebody in Palm Springs that's trying to Uber to...
That happened one time.
Wow.
That happened one time.
How much did you make for that?
I came out with like 170 something. But they paid like 220 something. It wasn't that bad, but it was.
Wow. Expensive. Fuck yeah. How many times did you stop to take a shit on the way? I get the feeling that, like, you start letting out a little couple farts and, you know, give them a little warning that it's coming. You're like, so I'm gonna pull over this next exit.
Especially you get that sonic bird in you.
Much to your surprise, I'm a professional Tony. So
a
no.
Professional? No shits the whole time?
No shits.
Wow, that's amazing.
You gotta get those 5 stars somehow.
That's right.
That's the way to do it. If your Uber driver takes a shit, you can give him 2 stars.
Okay. Matthew, I'd like to see you.
That's a rule.
I thought something big was coming. Like, he's got an Uber joke locked and loaded.
Tony, please. Brian's about to invite me to the Ice House.
That's right. Friday, 10:30, 10 o'clock. I'd like to have you there.
Matthew, this is one of the most... Yeah, can you move the burger one more time? Theo wants to stay. Can we get a picture of that somebody? Yeah, there we go. Josh Martin.
I want to be in the... Yeah. You got this? Yeah. I'll leave the mic up here. Just have the comic... performed by me.
I love that. Matthew Maloney, you killed it. This was a hilarious performance, all the way down to basically inviting yourself to the Ice House on Friday. I love it.
It's where I need
to be. Matthew Maloney is on Twitter at Matthew E. Maloney, all one word. He's the only guy with Matthew E. Maloney. Very fucking funny, Matthew. Please, come back. Do not have a heart attack. Come back. It's a big guy. Fucking just watch the butter and you'll be good, dude. Low butter for you. You're too funny. Everybody that's funny as fuck, like, always is like halfway about to die. Like, they're either on drugs or they're overweight. Like, it's like fucking crazy. But except for Theo and Fahim. How can I forget? He's too healthy looking. Funny as fuck. Two of the funniest guys.
I work with these guys all the time. I pulled another name out of the bucket. Kyle Shields.
Oh, shit.
Kyle!
Guy standing in the hallway. Kyle Shields, everyone.
What's up, everybody?
Hi, Kyle.
Hey. So, kind of overworking, you know. I don't really want to do it anymore. You know, like, why can't I just get by on my good looks, you know? That's why I think chicks got it easy, you know? You just got some nice boobs and pretty smile. And you're set, you know? There'll be a dude there. He'll pay for everything you need for the rest of your life, you know. You're good. That's why, thank you. That's why I think a lot of dudes decide to become trannies, you know. They figured it out, you know. There's some lazy-ass dudes that just figured it out. Like, get some boobs and some long hair. You're good. You might have to suck a few dicks, but hey, you don't gotta work no more.
Kyle Shields. This was your first comedy set ever?
No.
In that case, Kyle.
It's like six times.
Yeah, I was actually gonna guess less than 10. And here you are, I can feel it. And you know, that's what happens. Is when you very, very first started this, you're like, this shit's fucking brilliant. This is funnier than what I've heard other people say, and they got big laughs. And you're right, you know? You're right. If you get behind that joke and you fucking stand your ground and get passionate with it, you're right. Right now, you're just kicking out a premise that you have that is a good premise, and it just takes a while and it takes work to dig into that shit. Because you do have a point. You clearly have a passion for it. I'll tell you right now, I'll guarantee a chick just broke your heart within the past 6 months, right?
Because
you fucking hate women right now, dude. What you were saying is these lazy bitches don't have to do anything. Everything the guy does, we support everything. I'd rather cut off my dick and become a tranny than to have to deal with this shit.
There was a thick mustard or custard of misogyny at the top. And then there was a pause, and then the pause is, I think, where he got a little comfortable, because we loosened up a bit at the pause, and then he actually had a funny thought after, so I was like, that's all.
Do you work at FedEx? I used to work for UPS.
Wow.
Are those the UPS pants?
No. I wore it for the shirt, you know?
Right. Wow.
You need to really record your set, because you have a lot of little things that I focused on too much, where you said, you know so much. After everything, you go, you know. And that can really take you out of what you're saying. And so I was kind of, like, distracted with that. But
you look like you committed a crime today. What did you do? Something, at least jaywalking, right? Somewhere.
Yeah, I've jaywalked a couple times.
Not only are you sort of wearing the attire of a criminal, but you also have this very criminal haircut that I only see in like mug shots. That's sort of like, I don't know, I don't really think that's gel, and I don't really think it's grease. I think like it's a mix of the two that accumulates over a long period of time. And like in prison movies, you see that and they just comb it back. You don't really see them wash it or rinse it. It just keeps getting, am I close?
It's like 3 days without a shower.
There you go, boom, right? 3 days. You guys didn't know that, did you? No, I'm a studier of people. I looked at this fucking guy and I'm thinking, you're a dirty fucking criminal. And all I had to do was dig in a little bit. Let's say you find out the force of truth is out now. Thank you. We're getting there. Like I said, I'm warming up. So what's the last illegal thing you did, if you had to guess? Let's go truthies.
Just smoking weed, I guess. Besides, my card's expired, so I guess it's illegal.
All right, I guess, you know, you learn after a while of doing stand-up that the truth is the best way out. It'll set you free. And I think when you're on in 6 months to a year, you'll answer that question a little more honestly, because I think you did something shady recently.
Kind of nervous up here with those people.
Do you want a future?
High school counselor here.
I just quit my job, so it's like...
What was your job?
I worked for UPS for 10 years.
You worked for UPS for 10 years?
Wow.
That's
awesome.
Holy shit. Wow, the fucking...
boring Uber driver, that's right? Just packages in the back.
10 years is how long it takes you to find your voice as a UPS.
Boom! There it is. He's 1 for 27 tonight. But when it hits good. 10 years to find your voice. How'd you get through it? What do you listen to? Like, you one of those UPS drivers that's just fucking jamming to music? Like, I have a guy that, like, dances down the street with packages and shit.
Well, I never got to driving, you know, it was just part-time in the warehouse, unloading packages. And
oh, you never got the big promotion to driver that you always wanted. That's like the saddest thing I've ever heard. So you would just load up these trucks and you were like Rudolph and everybody's like, look at the guy that can't drive.
It broke my heart, so I had to let it go. I had to let go of the dream.
Did you ever find any weed or drugs?
Actually, yeah, there's been a lot of times where boxes have opened up, you know.
See, I feel randomly. Like this is the kind of guy, when you were working at UPS loading packages, I feel like you brought your own drug dog to sniff out packages, and you'd be like, good job, boy. You just take it.
That's basically everybody there has got a nose for drugs.
Right. So. I bet. Long hours there, right?
No, it's part-time, so.
So how long did it I'm trying to relate with this UPS guy. I have no fucking idea.
Awesome.
Driver, no, I worked in the warehouse, long hours, no. What's something that we'd be surprised to know about that UPS warehouse where all our shit's going through?
I break a lot of, well, people break a lot of boxes, step on them, smash them. Happens a lot.
I always wonder, why don't UPS or FedEx deliver people? Why is it only boxes? Like, why don't y'all do an airline?
Well, I mean, they do have airplanes, but I don't know.
But for like $30, if I could get my sister to fucking name.
Oh, yeah. Did you see Castaway? That seems like such a bad idea with like the boxes and the nets and the crushing.
Never mind.
You would think 10 years at UPS would help you with your joke delivery, but I was really surprised. It just really doesn't. I guess there's really no crossover there. But Kyle, I mean, that's fun stuff. You're going to be just fine. Are you having fun doing stand-up? You said six times. What's going on? Why?
Well, I only get up a couple times a week, you know.
Why is that? You're not working anymore.
He's part-time.
Part-time. That's my thing, you know. No, I just got a new job doing windows and doors, but that's...
The party horn for that one.
It's pretty fun. It's pretty fun.
Windows and doors.
Party! What are you doing with windows and doors?
Looking through them, opening them up.
I'm guessing by the way you're dressed, it's mostly windows you're going through. Brings it full circle, that criminal thing, for those of you paying attention on your Kill Tony bingo card. Kyle, somebody actually made one of those one time. Did you ever see that?
No.
Yeah, there's like Kill Tony bingo cards that have the things that happen. Like if I say fuck yeah, or if there's a horse of truth.
Yeah, there's
or whatever. Pat Reagan bombs. There's like all a bunch of spots that like you hit your little doinker on or whatever. Kyle, what do you like to do like when you're not smoking pot and you're not doing stand-up? Like what does a guy like you do? Like what's your shady fucking secret? What's your creepiest thing that you've Googled lately?
Oh, I don't know.
You're full of answers, aren't you, Kyle?
No, I do jiu-jitsu when I'm not doing this shit, you know, ride bikes around.
What belt are you in jiu-jitsu? Who do you train under?
He's a UPS guy, it's a brown belt.
I wish. My teacher's name is Dion Watts. He actually got his black belt from John Jock. He trained with Joe and.
Yeah, I believe he trained at the Hooters at Hollywood and Highland. If I have my story correct.
That's I actually bought my belt online. Yeah.
I love it. Well.
Wait, you bought? You didn't take a test. You just bought it online.
That was a joke. I found out that you could buy silicone breasts on eBay, so they're really cheap, so I might make a pillow out of boobs.
Oh, that sounds like a fun idea.
Mm-hmm.
Kyle, I want to get back into it a little bit, because again, your set was mostly about how women have it easy, and, you know, I mean, what happened? What happened because I know I was talking about, I didn't realize it, but... You know, the stuff that comes out of you when you're doing something like this, it's got to be coming from somewhere. So, when was the last time you were in a relationship with a girl?
Oh, well, I was just, yeah, it's just been a minute. No, I'm divorced, but...
Okay, there we go. See, we're starting to get somewhere, little Kyle. See, we need those answers. How long have you been divorced for?
It's been a while. 3 years. 3 years. Separated for 3 years.
You stalk her on Facebook a little bit?
No. I used to.
It seems like you're reliving memories from your relationship in your head.
Right now, yeah. Kind of, yeah.
Have you gotten a rebound since the 3-year divorce?
Yeah, but that didn't work out too well either.
Why is that?
No, I don't know. I don't know. Told her I did comedy. She's like, what?
That's what made her leave you? Let me hear one of those jokes. Goodbye!
When I was just starting off.
Anything else for Kyle, gentlemen? What do you got for Kyle? You're both good-looking guys. How about some fashion advice for Kyle? What are we gonna do with this guy?
You can change your pants after you quit your job.
Yeah.
All right. I like the chucks.
You can let the you can let the UPS go, and you know it's just like when you came up here, I'm like, is this guy here to do comedy or is he umpiring second base? Anyway, so maybe just feel it out, find your groove, Kyle. And next time you're up, fucking let it rip. Don't be shy.
All right.
And that muscle only gets stronger every time you go up. So if you really want to do this, go for it. You got nothing to fucking lose. And what'll end up happening is you'll get sort of funny. You'll end up getting that chick that you're mad at in the universe right now.
Please cheer the fuck up, man.
Yeah, have some fun, Kyle.
Yeah, I feel like you have a point of view and everything, and you want to get something across. And then the more you'll do it, you'll know where the actual punchline is. Because I think even when you're first starting out, like, the audience kind of approximated where to laugh. But we weren't quite sure of like where.
Okay.
So, yeah.
It was a good punchline. I thought it was going to be really bad, and then it was good. And and I think everybody thought that.
Well, there he goes, Kyle Shields, right. Everybody. 805 S Best. Number 805 S Best. Kyle Shields.
That's a area code is best. What is that area code? What's 805?
Ventura.
Ooh,
Ventura. I don't know if 805 is best.
No.
It's an interesting Twitter handle. All right, how about Darren Davis?
Hey, fuck yeah! All right, guys. Got some shit to say. Started dating online, but by accident, because I honestly believe that eHarmony was a website I could buy ecstasy on. I'm like, damn, I'm compatible with so many drug dealers. This is fucking amazing. So I decided to send them a dick pic, because that's what millennials do. And I found out that my dick doesn't fit in the frame, so I didn't send the proper dick pic. I was like, damn, that is a selfie stick wig. I'm gonna talk a little bit about Bruce Jenner. The guy's cool, I'm more of an animal rights activist. I'm more concerned about that man's pets. Like, yo, man, you can't just change your identity like that on a dog. That dog's in that mansion confused as fuck. Like, where the hell is Bruce? Ladies and gentlemen, y'all have a good fucking night.
Bruce Jenner's one of those things I won't even touch with a 10-foot pole. Like, it's just a topic that I haven't talked about at all because I work with Joe Rogan so often, and he has this amazing, fucking long, amazing Bruce Jenner joke. And then a few weeks ago, I caught Bill Burr, who has this long, amazing, a couple months ago, actually, I saw this long, amazing Bruce Jenner joke. And so, I'm just like hands off on it. And anytime I hear anybody bring it up, I don't even listen. But that there is such a funny fucking take. Really funny. You're a fucking funny guy. You got up here, you took the energy that Kyle left. Kyle let the audience really breathe and get well rested for the next funny comedian, and you took it and really ran with it. I would say you took the gloves off and let it rip, but no, you're actually the first person to ever perform in gloves. And obviously, it's clearly a tribute to O.J. Simpson. You came up here and killed with black gloves on in Los Angeles. Fuck, that's a triple joke, baby. Again, mark your fucking bingo cards, bitches. You're funny as fuck, dude. You have an amazing fucking, you know, powerful delivery. You believed in what you said, and one of my favorite parts is when a joke didn't go, you fucking coughed at it or something like that. I don't know what that was. But you saved it by, like, dissing your own flat joke. I'm always a big fan of, you know...
How long have you been doing comedy?
A year now.
Wow. You're gonna be a monster.
Yeah.
That's fucking incredible. Where are you from?
From the Valley.
Holy shit, that's shocking. That's really surprising. Most people as funny as you come from like a funnier place, like a tougher street or something like that, but no, you're just like a fucking little 15-minute drive away, huh?
Yeah, in the car.
Oh, I love that, right? You metroing it?
Yep.
That's amazing. The orange line, huh?
Yep.
Orange line to the red line?
Straight up.
Wow. Yeah, you get out to Hollywood Highland, then walk down, take the two?
Nah, skate.
Oh, but yeah, I wouldn't have taken you as a rollerblader. what's funny about that, and I'm really throwing myself under the bus about this, is that when I first got here to LA, actually it wasn't even when I actually, well yeah it was, when I very first got here I worked at the Beverly Hills Ruth's Chris Steakhouse waiting tables when I very first arrived. This was like a, I don't know, who gives a fuck? Anyway, but I didn't have a car either, and I did have rollerblades, I'm not even fucking kidding. I think I was 20. And I would get off, I basically rollerblade a mile downhill. Anyway, fuck it. Party horns! Rollerblading's up there with windows and doors tonight. Fuck yeah.
How much material do you have, would you say? Hmm? How much material do you have?
I don't really know. I usually do open mics, and like the most time I did was like 15 minutes at like some bar show.
Clothing-wise, you have a lot of material.
I guess so. Yes, I do.
The hat.
Oh, yeah, no, yeah. We got the hat. Thank you. Thank you. That's the only guy that tags things that don't work.
These cigarettes. Like that?
I love that. These cigarette references that are coming out of nowhere.
I was just tagging a joke that didn't work. All right.
Darren, you're funny as fuck. What have you been doing all your life? How old are you?
I'm 25.
Fuck yeah. What do you do for work?
I just started working at Macy's.
Oh, wow. You fooled them. What do you do there?
I just fix the clothes up, make them look real pretty and shit.
Get the fuck out of here. I do not take you for a Macy's guy. Like, I can picture you getting maced before working at Macy's. It's funny as fuck. Way too funny. You guys have like racial... He's laughing at it. Why aren't you white idiot tourists laughing at it? Think I have a loaded up Macy's joke in case somebody works at Macy's? No, I thought of that on the spot and he's black. People are so weird and touchy nowadays. You can't even make a topical fucking joke.
Yeah, like y'all didn't think he looks like an extra from Fruitvale Station, okay? Let's be honest.
I don't even know what that is. But that does sound... What is Fruitville Station?
I wouldn't have
thought you were super watching them.
Thank you. Way appreciate it.
Fruitville Station, the newest show on the KKK channel.
It's the exact opposite of that.
Oh, yeah, funny as fuck. E-Harmony, all that shit. What else is going on?
Just trying to finish up classes for the semester so I can go balls deep during the winter.
Oh, yeah.
Balls deep during the winter. What are you studying?
I'm studying English. Oh. Yeah.
Yeah. Balls deep English. Does shit look all nice? Monitoring in poetry.
Balls deep in English. Fucking incredible. How close are you to graduating?
I'm about to transfer to Cal State Northridge for like the next school year.
How many credit hours do you have left?
I don't fucking know. I'm just trying to get this shit over it.
Well, a lot of people don't know this. Sometimes we give out spots to the Ice House, and sometimes we do something else. We actually have a scholarship now. I'm just fucking around.
Fucking asshole!
Too long. I'm too real. Oh, that is
so funny if we had a Kill Tony scholarship for people that say they're in college. That'd be fucking mind-blowing. Once a month, we give them a year of free tuition.
Just give me a Chipotle brew and I'll be happy.
No, fuck. No, we're not going to do that either. What else? You just started this job at Macy's. How long have you been doing that?
Maybe 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
Yeah.
You're just making clothes look nice.
Did training, so like I got away from the game my actual schedule, so just chilling.
Can you make Friday night at the Ice House?
I can fucking make that shit.
All right.
Wow.
Look at that. Great episode tonight. Darren, you're a funny fucking dude, and in a year you're super dangerous. You clearly understand the importance of projecting and fucking getting their attention, and you also stay in the moment when the joke didn't work. You broke down the walls and were the first to make fun of it before the crowd could even be silent. And then you came over the top and did a really smart fucking Bruce Jenner take that I haven't heard and never thought of. And that's funny as fuck. Do you have more on Bruce Jenner?
No, I just like
you
to
should.
Fuck with his dog.
You should. Now that shit is so good that you have to connect it with your next thing. Figure out a way to maybe not stay on Bruce Jenner, but roll out of it smoothly so that you can have that. You know what I mean? That's such a good fucking joke. And when you do a lot of these open mics, like I'm sure you're doing, comedians will always laugh at fucking dick fart and shit and poopy shit and craziness. Keep writing smart jokes. Don't let those open mic laughs change you. You know what I mean? I notice a lot of people get in the habit of just trying to make those comedians laugh. And they'll laugh at your failure just as fast as they'll laugh at a good joke. And that Bruce Jenner joke's so good that that sounds like somebody that bombs a lot.
Yeah, those fucking people want to watch me fail.
Anyway. Darren, anything else for Darren, guys? Look at this bad motherfucker. Yeah, it's like a young Jamar Neighbors.
She was good, jokes were good.
Great.
Yeah.
I love it. Straight out of the valley. It's Darren Davis, everybody. He's out there. Good young comics coming through the ranks. Darren Davis, Matthew Maloney. A lot of alliteration. You set us off into alliteration. Ronda Rousey, Holly Holm, Darren Davis, Matthew Maloney.
There's patterns everywhere. You just have to look for them.
Oh wow, there you go. Somebody did mushrooms this weekend. Oh shit. No, I got it. Same one. No, that's a first. Your next comic never will have a chance in show business. Put your hands together for Eric Evanante.
So I was at the dispensary getting weed so I could write these jokes. And this hobo came up to me and he was like, "Hey man, do you have any change?" I'm like, "Sorry man, all my money is to buy drugs." And he's like, "That's cool, that's living the dream." I'm like, "Thanks, could you move your nightmare ass out of the way so I can get some drugs? It's personal for me because that's gonna be me in 2 years." So, if you ever see a... And so he was like, "Fuck you, man." He walked away. And this other hobo came up to me and he was like, "Hey, man, that was fucked up. Could I have some change?" And I was like, "No." He was like, "Damn. I thought good hobo, bad hobo was going to work there." If a hobo ever comes up to you and like you see this is about to happen, just be like, "Hey, man, do you have any change?" He'll be like, "No," and it's like, "It's cool, you can get me next time." Alright, and then...
Eric Evanante.
Well, I just like how natural you were up there.
It was like somebody was reading a text conversation back
before.
I love it. First of all, let's talk about the first thing that popped up. Pat, can you put the mic stand back where it was? Eric, you must be this tall in order to... I love that you left the mic stand right in front of you. You almost shadowed yourself with it. It was like some kind of creepy eclipse. So, how long have you been on stand-up?
42 days now.
42 days. Fuck yeah. Unbelievable number. I'm guessing you've done it twice in 42 days. The other time was 42 days ago.
One lint's worth.
What happened 42 days ago? What changed in your life?
Just bored as fuck.
Really?
Yeah.
What was going on before that?
Nothing. Just I'm an autism tutor and just got bored.
You're a what?
Autism tutor.
Autism.
To get rubbed off.
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't know autism was airborne. Fuck yeah. So 42 days. What happened? I mean, so are you still tutoring autistic kids?
Yeah, I still
tutor. So you tutor them. So that's not even like you're a teacher. You're helping them with extra stuff that they think they need help with.
No, it's just like, I actually teach them how to like read and write and shit. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's great.
Woo! Not as funny, sorry.
I meet a lot of girls that are in the spectrum, so I understand.
Meet or fuck?
You were saying something, Fahim, right? You know, early on at the beginning.
Yeah, or what? It's like I was gonna ask how long he's been doing it, but he told you 42 days. It's very typical. I mean, yeah, you're very new, and it's kind of you're trying to ride that line of like, what's the bit, and then all these people are looking at me. You know, how do I get it out? So you're like combating stage fright with remembering your material. And that'll like wash away with time.
Yeah,
you
stayed all on one joke, which is really, really good. It was really awesome. No hobo.
you really should listen to your sets though, because like your presentation was like a one-sided conversation. It wasn't really put into like a joke form. It was like more like, so then I talked to this guy and he was like, oh my god, I can't believe
you're always gonna notice that. And you know, a lot like Kyle Shields. You know, that's the difference between, you know, you guys and Darren Davis, who came up guns a-blazing with energy and a smile. Do you ever, what excites you? Because you seem like, you cry a lot.
I ate like five edibles before the show. I'm doing product photography for a weed company, and so it's like after you finish the photography, you're like, well, you have to eat it, so I ate it.
Well, you ate it on stage, too. It happens quick. Fuck yeah. So Eric, what excites you? You're high as fuck right now. So you really are about to cry. Like you're fucking tripping balls.
Nah, it's a typical
thing. What kind of edibles were they? Gummy bears? Or?
There were some pretzels. There was a Belgian chocolate. There was peanut butter.
You had pot pretzels?
Yeah, it's pretty magical world time.
Hold on, wait a second. We have something from Theo here.
Cigarette.
But why are you getting so high? I feel like you should probably be focusing a little bit more.
He's like my friend Scott.
What else am I doing?
No, but I think that can change, right? And I think Tony has some good ideas. Now you can probably get things headed into a better direction.
It's true. You know? Yeah, you gotta, you know, balance the things out. Do you work out?
No.
Right.
Obviously, I mean, did you have to ask
him? Well, I mean, not really. You could jog. But I know that
you're jogging with him. I would go on a hike with you. I think you're funny, and I could picture myself looking into your eyes and having a good conversation. Wow. I'd be like, this is a cool dude.
Fuck yeah. Cool. Pat wants to go on a hike. Clearly he wants you to wear loose-fitting clothing for that hike that you guys are going to go on.
I think you're funny. You got funny eyes.
High eyes. Yeah, I want to see how funny your cock is in my butt.
Jesus, Pat.
Your dick tastes funny. Right.
You're funny, but your asshole's hilarious. Eric, you ever had your heart broken?
Not really.
Not really. You're just fucking impervious to everything.
Just boring.
Unstoppable. Everything's boring to you, huh? Just even coming on a live show in front of 100,000 downloads, you're like, I need five edibles for this shit. It's my 42nd time on stage, so I got this. Alright, so nothing interests you. You have no hobbies.
I like, you know, shooting videos and shit. I like, you know, I'm kind of into, like, Woody Allen, so I, like, want to shoot stuff.
I bet. If you're anything like Woody Allen, you want to shoot on a five-year-old Korean doll. Hey, I didn't do it, guys. Woody Allen did it. So you're shooting, like, movies and stuff?
Yeah, I'm shooting a music video tonight, actually.
Oh, wow. Tonight, after this, after you did pot, product placement, and a spot.
$10 a gram dispensary, people.
What are you?
That's a plug.
Everybody has a plug tonight for some reason. This is like the new thing. It's turned into like a hip hop radio station. Yeah. Like, and my Uncle Charles, Charles, and my cousin Sally. It's like,
give a shout out.
Yeah, who does it? Hollywood Highland. So, you've been doing this 42 days. Now, what's the work ethic like?
I do it like two or three times. I try to get out two or three times a night. I mean, I know it doesn't show yet, but you know.
What do you do for money?
I'm an autism tutor.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. I somehow forgot already.
Yeah.
Those five edibles are rubbing off on me.
My high is contagious, yeah.
How are you doing so much drugs and teaching kids with autism?
Do you have to get down to their level just like, fuck, I don't even, I'm sorry.
I mean, it's fucking counting and like basic words. Like, how are you not doing drugs, you know?
That's so fucking funny.
Just write that down.
Yeah, absolutely. That's a joke that only you could do. You know, you teach autism kids and people, and you get high and people are like, how do you get high and do that? And it's like, one plus one is still two. I never get that high to where I'm dumber than an autistic kid. I mean, that's a joke only you can do, so yeah. Fucking, there you go, there's a little gift. That's what you get. Erica Benante, everybody, there you go. We're doing it tonight. Erica Benante is on Twitter, at Erica Benante, ABBENANTE. Fuck yeah, this is fun, right?
It's interesting.
It's interesting. I love it. By the way, I've noticed about the cigarette thing, it's gotten funnier every time. Yeah. I've never seen one go like from one, it's like, oh, it didn't work. Two, boom. Three, bang. I'm excited to see. Maybe there'll be a fourth cigarette callback. That's right. Let's get some fucking female energy up here, guys. Finally, we pulled a lady out of the bucket. Leah Mansfield, everyone.
Let's hear it for a lady! It's a shame I left my dick at home. Yeah, man. So, just let you take that in for a second. My dick is bigger than my right leg. It's fine. I had to buy it. A lot of people want to know if my name is Leah or Leia, and I'm like, you just call me sir, that's fine. Especially if you see me from behind first, you're like, I need help from that little boy. Thank you. I have terrible gaydar. I'm a gay. You guys all got that? Yes. I have terrible gaydar, like I pretty much just have hope-dar. Like, I see women, I'm like, man, I hope she's gay. She's not. If I'm into her, she's not. She's straight. If I can tell they're gay from a distance, I'm like, well, we can drink beer together. That's pretty much it. Has it been a minute? Or
oh, yeah, sorry.
Yeah, all right, cool.
What's amazing about it, sometimes the comedy gods just fucking hit a show right in the head. Out of all the times we've done this show, I have never been the guy, and I've hosted tons of shows, I'm never, ooh, a lady, everybody, ooh, a female. And I did it once, and then after doing it once, which I never do, I actually did it again, which is unbelievable. I'm like, ooh, some female energy. It's great to get a lady up to the stage. It's like, and never before have we had Leah Mansfield on the show, and it's just amazing to me how fun. I looked at the clock, it was 26 seconds in until you even had to start doing jokes. Literally half your set was spent just milking that, which is amazing, which is great, and that's exactly what a huge part of this is. Just as important as jokes is taking what's given to you and rolling with that momentum.
Your set was so good, I wasn't even paying attention to the clock.
Yeah, that's
awesome.
You were
12 seconds over.
Very, very fun. Amazing. You've been doing comedy a while.
I have. It's been almost 10 years. A little over 10 years.
Yeah. Yeah. It shows. You definitely have chops. Where you been?
Well, I started in Denver.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Great comedy.
Thank you.
Scene.
Yes. I love Denver. And then I moved to Vegas. That was terrible. And after a year in Vegas, I moved to Minneapolis. Yeah. Thank you. I loved Minneapolis. That's where I started on the road, was Minneapolis. Then I did a year and a half in Seattle, and then I moved to LA 2 years ago. So,
fuck yeah.
I don't like staying in one place or meeting people very well. So.
Typical lesbian gets around a lot.
am a huge whore, so.
That's so fun. That's gotta be a blast for you. Where's your favorite spot for the, for,
It's probably the vagina.
Out of all the stuff.
It's so ridiculous.
A willing vagina audience is always fantastic. I love it. Man, one of my favorite shows in the country is the Monday Night Comedy Show in Minneapolis. It's in just a basement bar. I love that show. Man, where
so
else
fun. So you've been doing it 10 years. How long have you lived in L.A.?
Two, just about two.
Hell yeah.
Have you been getting up a lot here?
Yeah, some here and there, you know. I'm parking cars at a hospital during the day, so that's how well comedy is going. It's fantastic.
Oh, you're not the stunt woman for Tig Notaro?
I know, right?
I just thought she's doing so much stuff now that she had a stand-in at least. But
really?
Well, when she does need one, I'm sure she'll
I know, I'm going to have to trim my boobs down a little, I think.
That's right.
They grew in like 14 years ago, and I want to cut them back anyway, but...
No, please keep
how going. Does that work? You know what I mean? Like, it's an interesting thing that obviously we would have no idea about, because, you know, I'd imagine, and maybe I'm like way out of line here, but I'd imagine in that lesbian game, you're more of the alpha, right?
I actually like a strong feminine woman who will make the first move.
Yeah.
In all of life except in bed, and then I'm in charge, right? Do what I say. Make me a sandwich. Whatever. She never does. I end up making the sandwich and coffee and everything. So, yeah. No, I'm definitely the butch. Like, I fall under the butch-femme dichotomy, which I never intended to do. It was not like you come out of the closet and you're like, I'm going to be a butch, and I'm only going to date femmes. But that's just how it ended up. So.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Now, do you identify as a young man or as a young woman?
I identify as a young woman.
You do.
People have asked me if I wanted to transition. I'm like, no, men smell like tree bark. I don't want to be a part of that. But I love like really feminine women.
Now,
and so yeah.
One thing that I think we've all noticed is that, let's face it, the more butch type of lesbian always gets the hottest chicks. Like, is that how it works with you? Or are you always walking around with, like...
Chubby chaser?
No. You know, I'm 38, so it used to be I dated just hot women. I had an ex-girlfriend who looked like a Swedish swimsuit model.
Right. That's what I was picturing.
But she was insane. She was insane. Yeah. So now it has to be, like, another component of personality where it's like, I have to get along, no drama... And you have to know about things like space, you know? Like,
right.
Do you know why Gravity, the movie Gravity, was fucked up? If so, and you're hot, then we can fuck, right?
So you need someone with a little brain.
Yeah, absolutely. My parents are scientists, and so I grew up around really smart people, and I really enjoy very long conversations followed by pussy eating. That's my favorite.
To have you on the show Friday also.
Awesome.
Wow.
Yeah,
it's all getting booked right in front of you.
Booking the whole show today.
It's happening right now. Leah,
right.
You are funny as fuck.
Thank
10
you so
years,
much.
Huh?
Yeah, yeah.
We have to figure out a way to.
Okay.
Yeah.
Get you
famous somehow.
Okay. All right. You know, that's cool. Woo! I'd be down. Even just like...
How much material do you have?
An hour. I mean, I can headline on the road, like really shitty one-nighters and stuff.
Have you ever made an album or anything?
No. I'm kind of... Tig Notaro is my favorite comic, and my hero, and she never recognizes me, which is fantastic, because I opened for her once, and I bombed, so I'm really glad
she doesn't recognize
me.
You? How's that possible? Like, if I was Tig Notaro and I saw you, I would think I was just walking by a mirror.
I don't need to be famous. I just want to not... park cars for cancer patients at a hospital.
Oh, it's cancer patients?
Yeah.
Wow, do sometimes you park their car and they just don't come back because they die? I'm just asking, hey, questions you can only ask the valet at a cancer place, all right?
Actually, there's days when you're like, all right, see you tomorrow, and then they just never come back. Yeah, and you're just like, well, they didn't tip anyway, so...
Fuck yeah, get out of here.
All right, thank you.
Get you out on a laugh. Leah Mansfield. Look out. She's coming. Leah Mansfield. Whoa. Holy shit.
It was great.
So fun. What a fucking crazy show. This is like old school Johnny Carson or some shit. We're seeing the future here tonight. This is the crystal ball episode of Kill Tony. Put your hands together for your next comedian. There's a little bit of a scratch out here and a fucking, so that I might be just like last time when I try to preface what I pulled out of the bucket, I might be wrong about the crystal ball thing. Put your hands together for Gary Curtis.
They say English is the hardest language to learn. I honestly believe that's only because they haven't declared woman as a language yet. Now, I was having this conversation with my girlfriend. Well, fellas, have you ever been having a conversation with your girl and then you realize that you're in the middle of an argument? Like, how the fuck did I get in here? So we're having this conversation and then she ends it going, "See, I was right. I'm always right." I was like, okay. So I'm leaving later that day. I was like, "Bye, baby. I love you." Mwah. She was like, "I love you more." I was like, "You right." And, and she got mad. I said, "How can you get mad? You just told me you're always right." She was like, "Well, not now." I said, "Always means always." She was like, "Not now." I was like, "Oh, okay, so since you're always mean something different than my always, sure, we'll always be together." All right, Josh.
There you go, 55 seconds of thunder. Very Curtis. Very, very funny. You've been doing comedy a while too, huh?
2 years.
2 years, wow. You have a good look. Everything is, I think, what Red Band would call on fleek.
On fleek.
Yeah, especially the eyebrows. Wow.
You take good care of yourself. You shaped, you chiseled that today, right?
Yeah,
that beard.
Definitely, yeah.
I mean, that's as fresh as it gets.
You gotta look good for the podcast.
This is for the podcast, yeah.
All right.
You
have to look good for it. You got that cardigan clearly from, straight from the closet of Drake.
that's what I was going for today.
Yeah. I love it. Where are you from?
Originally from Jersey.
Wow. Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. It's amazing that you shave regularly. Normally people from Jersey don't even shower. So that's pretty amazing.
I feel like
yeah.
The audience is wet for you.
I like to have the audience is wet for me.
Yeah, I think Pat's just gay tonight.
Yeah, Pat's super gay tonight.
Was it just tonight?
I'm pretty sure you made Pat's butt wet is what he said.
No?
I don't think so.
No?
Uh-oh. You know what that sound means. It's time for Pat to show his wet butthole. Let's see that wet bugger.
That's Sam, man.
Gary, it's true. I can sort of see what Pat is saying, though. There's something, it looks like you're sort of like an R&B singer doing comedy. You know what I mean?
You need to do females-only shows like Teddy Pendergrass. I'm going to get that reference, but...
All right, and then Pat wants you to invite him to those only shows. He'll be in the fucking front row waiting for you to bust out the tearaway pants. Pat, I love it. You're like leaning in closer.
Yeah,
I'm
really trying to get my back to him.
Getting hella gay right now. Bro. I'm like watching like a little gay thing morph out of you, bro. You're like a little gay moon. Just
I feel like there's a fleshlight. I feel like there's a fleshlight attached to the back of your guitar right now. You're just molesting yourself. Gary, so this is your first time on the show, right?
Nah, I did a couple, a few, like 3 weeks ago. Yeah. I think
it was. Oh, really? What'd you do? Yeah. Bleach your skin afterwards or something? Why can't I remember?
Nah, I don't know.
So you were too busy looking at his dick.
It was with Joe and Ian.
Oh, okay. That's fun. How did that go?
Well,
yeah,
you
fun times.
You guys liked it.
Yeah. That's cool. So, what else is going on? You were originally from Jersey. How long have you lived in LA?
I've been in LA 2 years.
Where do you live?
I live like around the corner from USC. Off Vermont.
Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah. That's an interesting area.
Vermont, what?
There it is. Pat wants that cross street, everybody. Will he get it? It's time for another fun segment we call Pat Wants That Cross Street. We already have Vermont. Gary, is it north or south of Sunset?
Oh, it's south of Sunset.
Oh, it's south of Sunset. You know what that means? Waiting for that chorus. You have to put it in the chorus.
clearly waiting for the middle of the first verse. If you didn't play now, it's probably going to happen.
That's right. I'm waiting for it.
All right, we'll wait for it. I'm gonna set it up, and then you'll be able to hit it. All right. Is it south of...
Nah, come on, man.
Pat, where do you live?
I used to live in Vermont and 37th place when I went to USC.
Oh, are you close to that?
Yeah.
It's kind of timing. I feel like that's the only time I've ever heard that first verse to "It's Raining Now." It's on this show for 15 seconds longer than it should have been. It's like a totally different song. Oh, fuck. Gary, you dress well. What do you do for work?
So, I'm a treasury analyst. I help manage companies' cash.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah. I used to work in banking. Then I came here, got like on the corporate side. I worked at a company, but I told them I'm quitting today to go to a different company.
Yeah. Damn.
Yeah.
You're just laying down the law.
Yeah.
Love it. Treasury, huh? Yeah. You're just working with money.
Yeah, that's it.
That's fun. You ever take some?
Yeah, I wish. Back when I used to work at the bank, I did, but not, you know.
You did?
Yeah.
Is that easy to do at a bank?
When you're a teller, it used to be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I probably shouldn't incriminate myself.
Hopefully there's a statute of limitations.
Yeah,
like
it's
that.
Definitely, yeah. That was back in the day, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Way back.
Wised up.
Your Honor, it was way back in the day.
And it was just a sperm bank.
I mean, like, who's really the thief here? Me or the bank? Let's be serious.
Right.
Man, brother.
They are. Absolutely. You took that shit.
Yeah, let's get political.
I love it. Well, fun times, Gary. It was nice to meet you. Thanks for coming on the show.
All right.
What else is going on? Anything else?
Shit.
You getting up a lot, Gary?
There's so much. Not that much every now and then.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I saw you at the parlor. I opened up at the parlor.
Oh, right on. That's fun over there.
Ago. Yeah.
So you getting up?
I do a bunch of videos with BuzzFeed and shit. That shit, it's fun. Sometimes.
Tell them to stop ruining our Facebooks.
Yeah.
What happens next to this girl?
Yeah.
All right. Fun stuff, man.
Gary, very fun. Thanks for coming on the show. He's on Twitter at GKurtCSB. Gary Curtis. This part of the show, we are going to go outside of the bucket for our one and only regular. Every single week, we have one girl who writes and performs a new 60 seconds every single week.
I want to see that.
She is the newest regular here on Kill Tony. Put your hands together for the always adorable stylings of the likable and nervous Melissa Esslinger, everyone.
People used to ask me if I ride the short bus. I thought they were making a size joke. Short bus. A lot of people spend a lot of time trying to think outside of the box, but I'm still trying to figure out how to get in it. I looked up normal in the dictionary. It said not abnormal. So I looked up abnormal, and it said, not normal. Fuck you, dictionary. It's not very helpful. Kind of put the dick in dictionary. Is that a minute? Oh, shit.
53 seconds. You have a 6-second joke?
You got one
more.
Yeah, I'm so sure that, like, automatic doors don't open for me.
There you go. A new minute from all the sass. The party horn is out. Keep the mic up. You did it again. That's another new minute. That counts. I would definitely, you know, when you do a short joke about the short bus,
you don't have to
wait and see and react to their reaction. You know what I mean?
You don't really even have to do that joke.
Plow forward. No, that's not true. Don't listen to Red Band. He always tries to play bad cop with a regular. And that's not true. That joke's perfectly fine if it's cluttered between other short stuff. If you're talking about being small and people fucking with you, then it makes sense. What comes after that joke, it shouldn't just be a one-liner. You know what I mean?
Makes sense.
It's more of a semi-premise. You know what I mean? Short bus, ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. It could be anything before or after it, but...
to let it stand on its own, that's where you're going to get in trouble. Yeah. Had you done the short bus and then the automatic doors, or the automatic doors and then the short bus, you'd get a different reaction from the short bus. Right. But letting it stand on its own.
Lump all your topics together so you have a chunk instead of just a standalone
joke.
Or you could even preface it by saying, I'm small. When I thought people used to fuck with me when they were saying, want to ride the short bus. Like, no, I want to ride the tall bus or whatever. You know, you can go anywhere with it.
Yeah.
But you just have to beat it out. Because I don't really think you're a one-liner person.
Yeah.
Right.
And it's fun to test out premises here, and that's exactly what it's good for, is for you to hear it and to see how to work around it. But I've never heard anybody make a short joke off of a short bus thing, so it's not hacky, so you're on to something. And the automatic doors, is that true? Let's get into it more.
Yeah, actually it is true. Especially like there, it doesn't happen at like every automatic door. I haven't figured out what causes it, what kind of sensor it is.
Right.
But these are the things I think about when I approach doors that say automatic on them.
You can
like, am I gonna have to jump? Am I gonna have to wave my hands up? Am I gonna have to do this? Or I can just casually wait till somebody's like walking with me.
There you go.
There
it is. That's how it happens.
You need to bring a date to an automatic door.
Exactly.
Theo,
he's
Mike.
Sorry.
Theo's the first ever. Theo's the first guy to podcast history to go no mic on it. So, what was that?
I said Melissa. Just because we've seen you for now, I don't know how many weeks, but you are doing a lot of really short jokes and that aren't fleshed out. So, I mean, just work harder at expanding whatever that thought is, whatever that germ or that idea is, just let it grow, put it on a petri dish.
And wonder what we would ask you. It's getting to the point to where, you know, you're seeing it sort of. I'm always going to say if it's a one-liner super short joke, you know, to beat it out and to figure out what the beginning and what the end is. We just did then. That clearly the automatic doors thing, jump, wave, take a date to the automatic doors is clearly a joke for that.
I mean, I haven't seen her trajectory at all. I've only seen, like, tonight.
Right.
Maybe it's an exercise, like, an entire minute next time just about one topic.
Yeah.
Because that's not a crazy task, just to talk about something at length for a minute.
Right.
That's not... Yeah, it kind of force you to do that.
Don't even get me started on Gary Curtis.
There you go. That's a, for you podcast listeners, that was actually him shooting himself after that. No, but you know, I mean, it's all good because, and by the way, this is something that we saw with our two other regulars for 2 years, you know what I mean? It's not necessarily completely out of the question for during a tough week if, and I've seen you do one subject before, I think it was even last week.
I think only
week.
One, I think it
anyway,
was.
Anyway, it's not terribly out of the realm to bring, you know, sort of premise ideas here and let fucking creepy minds flesh them out a little bit for you, you know what I mean? Because that's sort of what we do. So I also like that. So, you know, there's definitely a balance between everything. And, you know, just keep chipping away. Because it's also one thing that I'll say to expand on what Fahim was saying is that you'll be amazed how much easier it is to get laughs off of one subject than it is to change direction. And what you did is the ultimate, you know, toughest thing to do because you started with a short joke, went into another joke, and then went back to a short joke, which it's like, you know, then you're really separating. You're making it so much harder on yourself than you have to. Whereas once people are already in on a subject, it's much easier for them to digest the next joke on that. Melissa Esslinger is going to be a monster, ladies and gentlemen, and she's being built right here at Kill Tony, writing and performing a new interview. What happens?
One quick one.
Tam Fam, everybody.
Hey, when I quit my job, I had to slash my food budget so much that in 3 months, I went from 160 pounds to 120. I wasn't fat to begin with. In fact, I set an unofficial world record as the skinniest person ever to lose 40 pounds in 90 days. Non-AIDS division. not, I'm too skinny and too short to be attractive to anybody aside from pedophiles. So, I once thought that maybe I should like convert to Islam just to be eligible for 72 virgins, but how awkward would that be? Imagine what would happen if I was alone in a room with 72 virgins. There would be 73 virgins.
It's amazing. What's funny is, like, when you were halfway through the 72 virgins joke, I was actually going to give you the joke that you said is the punchline. And so you got it. That's a funny joke, TamFam.
You got it.
You nailed it. TamFam, how are things going? You are the most Asian-looking motherfucker I've ever seen. Like,
I disagree with that.
Really?
Yeah,
but go on.
How are things? You've been one of our fun people that have regularly gotten pulled out of the bucket. You have that famous Asian luck that they all have at the casinos. You've pulled out of the bucket a lot. How are things going? We've seen you a few times. How's the progress?
Going pretty well, yeah.
You used to wear a shirt that said @TamFamComedy on it. You were very popular for that. On Twitter, right? It also said that, as if people couldn't figure out @TamFamComedy was your Twitter handle. You've gone no @TamFamComedy. We saw him 4 or 5 times wearing the branded shirt, and he started going no shirt, and things started going a little bit better for you. How's that working out?
Sets are going pretty well. I'm not sure if it's the shirt or not, but I think people are liking my stuff more. I cut out a lot of the worst jokes. I'm just sort of filtering stuff down to my best material right now.
I don't really get that. Out of all the jokes I've heard you say, the 160, 140 seems like a long setup. What are you saying there? Were you really 160?
Yeah.
And then you got down to 140?
120.
And why? How?
I quit my job and just had to cut down on,
food.
Expenses. Yeah.
What were you eating?
Food.
Chicken and...
Go on, say it. Rice, motherfucker. Say rice. You piece of shit.
But several of them.
Fall into my trap, TamFam. Good news is he'll be performing at the Rice House this Friday, everybody. No, I'm kidding. Bye, TamFam. There he goes. That's the episode, everybody. We got Ryan J. Ebelt makes art every single week for the show. He drew tonight's episode with Fahim Anwar. Follow him at Fahim Anwar and check out his many great things. Theo Buzz, check out his special on Netflix. You have it, watch it. That's coming out in February. Theo Bond and Fahim Anwar. Patty Reagan is Patty Reagan. Melissa Esslinger, Jamie Vernon, at Josh Martin Comic, Ryan J. Ebelt. I'm Tony Hinchcliffe.
I'm Red Band.
See you guys soon. Thank you, live audience. We love you. Goodbye. Touch you, run and rough, you're out of bounds. I want you smothered, want you covered. I want gold pounds, hash browns, got the click of FedEx, never reach an apex, just like Eagles. Now you are inclined to make me rise an hour early, just like me. I say it's time. You and me, baby, ain't nothing but mammals, so let's do it like they do on the Discovery Channel.
Our next comedian from Kill Tony Podcast on DeathSquad.tv, live taping every Monday at the Comedy Store in LA. Tony Hinchcliffe is joining us. Kill Tony podcast on DeathSquad.tv, live taping every Monday at the Comedy Store in LA. Tony Hinchcliffe is joining us.